So in this lecture, we are going to look at the packed palette. So for that, let me show you an example. So what I will do is I will go to this this marquee tool and I will select these. Okay. And after that, I'll just simply press delete to delete all this. Okay. So I will again go to this arrow tool. Okay. So now what I will do is I will just press escape. Okay. To get out of this marquee tool. Okay, so I just want to show you something. Let's look at the pet palette. So first, for that, what I will do is I will choose the wall tool here. I will draw a wall from this point to this point, and you can see that we have successfully drawn a wall. So what I'm going to do next is that I will select this wall. Okay, let me press escape, and we will go to again arrow tool. Just press escape one more time, and you just simply need to select this wall. And if you again select on this wall, you will get these options here. So basically, this is the pet palette. You can see that I have selected this wall, and I can just move, drag this wall here just like that. Or what I can do is I can rotate this wall from, let's say, from this end to this end, just like that. Or what you can do is you can create a mirror just like that. Or what you can do, there are many lots of options. So this is the use of the pet palette. Also, I would like to show you one more thing, is that if I click on this at the middle, okay, earlier I have clicked on this edges. So if I this time I click on this center part, you will see that the options are a bit different than what we are getting at the edges. As you can see here, now we are getting these two options as well. So if I just click on this one, and I can just click here, and I can just make some changes here as well, as you can see here. Or what if I just go and select this option? In that case also, I will have a something like this. Okay, so you need to keep this thing in mind, is that after selecting that, if you change the position from this into, let's say, if you select at this end, the pet palette will be different, the function will be different. If you select at this end, the pet palette and the function and all these things will be different. You can see that right now we are getting the option of the extension. So this pet palette automatically adjusts itself as per the selection region as well. Okay. And it also changes as per this one. It also changes as per the element you are going to choose. So this time we have chosen the wall. So what will happen if we go ahead and we will select the beam tool? Okay, so let's go and draw a beam here. Okay, we have drawn a model a beam here. So what I will do is I will go to the select tool option, and I will just click here, and again I will click on this one. Now this time you will see that you are getting this pet palette option. So this changes as per the location where you have selected, also which element you have chosen. So now let's say that I will go and select this slab tool, and I will simply go and model a slab like this. And after that, I will press escape, and then I will select this one, and this time I will go ahead and select here. So now you can see that the pet palette option is a bit different from what we have chosen earlier. We have seen these two cases. So this is the pet palette. Okay, it will changes as per the location of the element. Okay, it will changes as per the type of element you choose. So you need to keep this thing in your mind.